trends. Today I'm going to talk about my August TBR, and I'm really excited for this TBR because I will be joining the Summer Fling Readathon. It is created by Sarah from Steeped Books and co-hosted by many wonderful booktubers. I follow many of them, and with the announcement of this video, I started following them all. They are all wonderful people. Sarah, for the previous, I think, 2 years, have been doing Summer Romance Book Bingo, which I have participated. It was a bingo card of 25 prompts, and 1 year I did just one row, and in the other year I did the letter H. This year she decided to make this a monthly readathon for August, and I had been actually putting off some books in my TBR for this readathon. Sarah and her co-host created a bingo card of 12 prompts. You can do just one row, or just one column, or a blackout if you wish. And I asked them if it's possible to use the same book for multiple prompts, and they said it's perfectly fine. So that's what I'm going to do actually. Sarah's announcement video and her co-host will be linked down below. But before my Summer Fling TBR, I'm going to talk about the three books that I will not, that are not romance books. The first one is the eighth book in Anne of Green Gables series, Rilla of Ingleside. I'm reading this book with the Goodreads group Annealong 2020, for stacking the series challenge. So far there hasn't been a book that I didn't like. There were some books that I liked less, but especially I especially like last month's books, and I'm really eager to read this one as well. The second book that I will read in August is The Sign of Four by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. I will body read this with Naomi from Naomi's bookshelf. After I finished my book of all of the short stories of Sherlock Holmes in Turkish, we decided to read a novel of Sherlock Holmes for the following first month, so that we will be finished with his longer works. We both read the first book, A Study in Scarlet, in July. Actually, I finished the book just today. I'm really enjoying the body reading experience, and it has been a great discussion of our feelings, our likes and our dislikes. I'm also very eager to body read the second book with her as well. And since I started my channel in August of 2019, starting from this month, I will add a book from BookTuber's recommendation from last year's. What I mean by that is that I started taking note of BookTuber's recommendations since I started my channel. I looked at the recommendations that I took note of in August of 2019 and chose a book for my August TBR. My plan was to choose a romance book since I'm doing Summer Fling Readathon, but unfortunately I couldn't find any romance books. So I decided to choose a historical fiction. At Wolf's Table by Rosario Postorino. This book was recommended by Russell at Ink and Paper Blog at one of his wrap-up videos. When I saw that I had it on my online application, I decided to choose this book to read in August. So let's get on with the books that I'm going to read for Summer Fling Readathon. As I mentioned before, Sarah created a card for all the prompts, and I will put the card here. The first prompt is Down Home Country, which means that we can choose a book from a local environment, or a book that takes place in a small town. I decided to choose a book that takes place in a small town, and I'm going to read one of the Stacking the Series books, Waiting on You by Kristan Higgins. Actually, the name of the series is the name of the town, so it definitely takes place in a small town. The second prompt is Big City Life. For this prompt, I'm going to choose a nostalgic book. I do for now. By JoAnn Ross. I also found this in my online bookmate application. And this book takes place in Phoenix, which is certainly a big city. The next prompt is The Author of Color. I'm going to choose a book that has been on my TBR for a very long time. The Kiss Quotient by Helen Hoang. For the next prompt, which is Hot and Spicy, I'm also going to choose The Kiss Quotient by Helen Hoang again. Because I've heard that it has some very sexy scenes. For Dark and Dangerous, I've chosen a gothic romance, Bride of Pendorric by Victoria Holt. I actually chose this book because of another prompt, but it was already on my TBR, so one more book down on my TBR, which is wonderful. For Sweet and Clean, I chose Waiting on You by Kristan Higgins again. Kristan Higgins writes feel-good romances, and although some sexy times happen in her books, it happens behind closed doors, so it can be considered clean. The next prompt was Road Trip. I chose a graphic novel for this prompt. I really wanted to read a graphic novel that is not horror or biography. So I chose The Less Than the Epic Adventures of TJ and Amal. It's a male-male romance. And it also includes a road trip, and also it's a graphic novel and it's short, so it was the perfect book for this readathon. For the prompt of Friends to Lovers, I'm going to choose the fourth book in Blue Heron series by Kristan Higgins, In Your Dreams. I read the short synopsis of the book, and it looks like a Friends to Lovers romance. And also, this will be another book that I will read for my Stacking the Series challenge. For Diverse Trip, I chose the Less Than Epic Adventures of TJ and Amal. It's a male-male romance, so it will be a perfect fit for this prompt as well. For Disability Representation, Sarah, in her video, explained that heroes or heroines living with a condition can be used for this prompt. So I chose The Kiss Quotient again for this prompt. Our hero suffers from Asperger's. That's why she hires a male escort to become more intimate. For old school historical, I chose Bride of Pendorric. Sarah said that we can choose a book that takes place in historic times, a book that was in our mother's bookcase. And I chose Victoria Holt, who had many books in my mother's bookshelf when I was a teenager, and I read some of her books and sort of enjoyed them. So I'm really eager to try them again after maybe 20 years. So that prompt was actually the reason that I chose Bride of Pendorric for Dark and Dangerous as well. And for category romance, I'm doubling up again. I'm choosing I do for now by JoAnn Ross. As I've said before, I found this in my bookmate application, and it's an imprint of Harlequin. I think it will be an interesting read for me. So those were the books that are on my August TBR. Please comment down below. Are you also joining Summer Fling Readathon? Also, what is the book that you're most excited to read for August? And if you're a new viewer, well, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye. A As for Turkish Word of the Day, since I'm joining a Summer Fling Readathon in August, I thought summer should be the word of the day. Summer means yaz. Turkish and yaz is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day.